we have another jazz initiative today. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a Dublin coddle. Okay, so we have our sausages, we have our ham pieces, we have our potatoes, we have our mixed veg, leeks, carrots and celery already chopped up, we have our onions, we have our vegetable stock, and we're probably going to use 2 stock cubes, we have our pepper, our parsley, our chives and our sea salt. Okay, so these are the ingredients that we're going to use for our coddle. Our coddle is going to be a thick dinner coddle. So again, sausages, our ham pieces, our bacon pieces, our potatoes, our mixed veg, our stock cubes, our salt, our pepper, our chives, and our parsley. Okay, so you can see here the price is €2.99 for the sausages, €4 for the ham pieces, €1 for the potatoes, €2 for the veg, €1 for the onions, and then the stock cubes. So we have 3, 7, 10, 11. So for about €13, we're going to have 4 to 6 portions. So we've opened our packaging, and there's our lovely ham bacon pieces. We're going to dice them up, and we have our sausages. We're after cutting our sausages up, and we have our mixed vegetables, and we have our carrots, our leeks and our celery. Okay, we're after dicing up our baby potatoes, and we have our stock cubes here. We're going to use 2 stock cubes, and we have our onions. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to boil the kettle, and we're going to make our stock first of all. So here we are, and we have our boiling water, so we're going to pop in our 2 stock cubes. We're going to give it a stir, and we're going to let our stock cubes dissolve. So what we're going to do is now we're going to dice up our onions and dice up our bacon, and we're going to start putting the preparation together now for the coddle. So there we go, we've chopped up our onions and we've chopped up our ham pieces just into into large pieces. Okay, so we've chopped up our ham pieces, and we've chopped up our onion, our potatoes are all ready to go, so is our vegetables, so is our sausages. Okay, so what we're going to do is now we're going to start adding the vegetables into our stock. Okay, so our onions are going in, our potatoes are going in, okay, and our mixed vegetables, our carrots, our leeks are going in. So we're just going to give that a stir, and we're just going to let them, we brought the stock to the boil, so we're going to let the vegetables simmer in there. Okay, so in the meantime, what we're going to do is we're going to seal off our sausages, and we're not, on a pan with some olive oil, we're just gently going to seal off our sausages. Okay, we're not going to colour them, and we're just going to seal in the flavour of the pork sausages. Okay, so we just put them back on over a gentle heat, and we're just going to seal off the sausages, and then we're going to add our sausages into the pot of stock with the vegetables. So a nice hot pan, seal off our sausages on both sides, and then we'll add them into the pot of vegetables. Okay, so there we go. A little bit of colour coming into the sausages. We're just sealing the flavour into the sausages in a nice hot pan. So our sausages are sealed off, okay, just lightly coloured. We're going to add our sausages now into our coddle, okay, and we're going to give it a good stir. Okay, so the reason why we sealed off our sausages is to seal all the flavour into the pork sausages, and for not for the sausages and to shrivel up. Okay, so there we are. We have our sausages into the pots now. So the next step is we're going to do the exact same with our bacon. Add a little bit of olive oil into the pan, and we're going to seal off our ham slash bacon pieces. Okay, we're just going to seal the flavour of the bacon or ham in the pan here, and then we're going to add it to our puddle mix in the pot. Okay, so again, we're not looking to really colour the bacon, we're just looking to seal it off. Okay, so our bacon is sealed off here. So you can see here our ham pieces and our bacon pieces are nicely sealed off. They're not overly coloured. So we've sealed all the flavour of the bacon and ham into, you know, it continues to stay in the meat. Alright? So that bacon now is nicely sealed off. And what we're going to do is now we're going to add the bacon into the pot with the sausages and the vegetables. So in we go, we've got all them lovely juices as well of the bacon pieces into the pot. Okay, so we have, so we're just going to give it a stir here, and you can see here we have our vegetables, we have our sausages, we have our potatoes cooking away in the stock. So we're going to let this cook away here on top of the cooker for about 30 minutes. Okay, it's going to take about 30 minutes for the coddle to be completed. Okay, so what we're going to do is now we're going to add a little bit of seasoning to our coddle. We're going to put in some sea salt. Okay. We're going to add in some black pepper, which we have here. A tiny piece of black pepper, not too much, because we don't overpower the coddle with pepper. And we also have some dried parsley. Alright, so the only seasoning that we need is salt, pepper, and some parsley. Okay, so it's very important that you continue to store the coddle over its cooking period because it, you know, as it's cooking, it could stick to the bottom. So it's very important that we give it a good stir and that it doesn't stick to the bottom and that everything gets cooked at the same time. Okay, so there we can see our ham, bacon pieces are cooking away, our sausages, our potatoes and our vegetables, our leeks, our onions and our carrots. Okay, so we're 10 minutes into the cooking, we have another 20 minutes to go. And we're just going to let the coddle simmer away and let all the flavours come out of all the ingredients that's in the pot. So there we are, our coddle is on now 30 minutes, okay? So we're going to check that all the ingredients are cooked. So we have our fork here, so our sausages are cooked. Our potatoes are cooked as well, the fork goes through the potatoes. So everything is cooked there, so we're just going to let it simmer away, and what we're going to do is now we're going to work on thickening the coddle. So what we're going to do is we're just going to put on simmer and we're going to thicken the coddle now. We're going to add some olive oil into a bowl. Okay, just about that much of olive oil. I'm going to add in now about two tablespoons full of flour. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to make what they would call a roux. Alright, so we're going to thicken our coddle with a roux. Okay, so it's flour and olive oil just to make it look, it should look like a paste. Okay, so what we're going to do we're just going to add in a knob of butter, about an ounce of butter into the roux as well. Okay, so we're going to stir that, we're going to let it settle, and then what we're going to do is then we're going to add the roux then to the coddle to thicken it. So here we are, we have our roux, we're going to add our roux into the liquid, into the coddle. So what this roux is going to do, it's going to thicken the coddle. So as soon as we add in the roux, we're just going to keep stirring. You can see the colours of the change in here. We also put a knob of butter into the roux, just for to give it the coddle an added flavour. Okay, so we're going to let the coddle, the flour and the roux cook out for another 10 or 15 minutes, and you'll see then the coddle will have thickened then, and it will have a nice consistency. Okay, so we're just going to let the roux cook out and thicken, and our coddle will be ready in the next 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, so we're 30 minutes into the coddle cooking, and it's all the meats and the flavours and the potatoes and all the vegetables are cooked. We've added in our thickening agent now, which is our roux. We're just going to let this cook out for another 15 minutes. So within 45 minutes, we have a coddle. There we go, folks. After the best part of an hour and 5 minutes, our coddle is completed. Okay, so we can see everything is cooked. Our liquid, our stock is after taking up with our roux. We have lovely flavours in here, and we've lovely colours. So what we're going to do is now, we're going to serve the coddle. So the best kitchen utensil to use when you're serving the coddle would be a ladle. So we're going to ladle the sausages and the vegetables and the soup into a bowl. Okay, so it's always best to use a bowl. So we're probably going to have maybe two sausages per portion, or maybe three, depends on whose portion it is. So if it's mine, it's going to be three. So there we go. So there's one portion of Dublin coddle. We have another one here. Now we're just going to ladle it up. We're just going to do two bowls. So out of this pot, we probably get six portions of coddle out of the pot that we have here. Alright, so it's very important capture all the ingredients. So what we're going to do now is, as you can see now, our coddle is complete. It's ready to be served, and we're just going to sprinkle some chives on it just to give it a little bit of colour. Okay, so there we've a nice bit of colour. We've all our lovely ingredients in there: our potatoes, our carrots, our leeks, our onions, our sausages, our bacon ham pieces, and our stock. We thickened it then with a roux, and we cooked it out for 30 minutes first, and we added the roux, we cooked it out for another 15 minutes. So with the prep and everything that we had to put into the coddle, and you're talking the best part of maybe an hour and 5, an hour and 10 minutes. Okay, so please have a go and enjoy.